Okay, Dave here again. Today I'm going to be shooting another circuit board. Today it's going to be, a number of circuit boards. I'm going to end up getting 12, 16, 17 circuit boards out of this one 6x6 shoot. Okay, so I'm going to use the MG Chemicals single-sided pre-sensitized copper clad board. Cat number is 609. Okay. Okay, so the first thing you got to do is take the board out of the package and remove the coating, the plastic protective white sticky coating that's on the board, so that you can expose the surface. So very lightly I peel back one corner like so. Hoping you can see that. Good. And then very slowly peel it off. And that leaves the green pre-sensitized area. And occasionally, some of the coating comes off, as you can see here. So I'm going to make sure that that's positioned on a spot on the board where it's not going to make any difference. So place the board in under there. Take my artwork, which I created using CorelDRAW, and print it onto a transparency with a colored printer. Okay. Now, I find a spot where that's not going to bother anything. Yes. So we'll just rotate it around like so. Well, it seems to be pretty dirty under there. Okay, get my artwork placed on top, like so. Make sure it's all lined up, and then clamp it down. Okay, now I've got a little egg timer here set for 7 minutes. Push start, turn on my light. Okay, in this tray I've got the developer, which is MG Chemicals number 418. Okay, and it is mixed 1 part to 10 parts water. Okay, so you can just see the pattern on the board, sort of like green and light green, dark green spots. And now I got my glove on, I'm ready to develop this. So I just drop it into the developer and then agitate the developer, and you will see the pattern appear almost immediately. And you want to keep agitating until the streaks go away. Like so. And it'll leave the photo etch resist wherever the dark patterns were on my transparency, and remove the photo etch and leave bare copper where you want it to etch. So you can still see it streaking there, Just leave it another couple more shakes here. And there, she's getting pretty well done now. That's it. So now I'll pull it out. And there you can see the pattern pretty clearly on there. Okay, now I just rinse it in some clear water, clean water. Now, the developer, you can use it over and over and over again, probably about 5 or 6 times, depending on the size of your boards. So I just put it into a clear bottle like this, and I mark exactly what it is and the date that I mixed it up. Okay, so now it's time to put the ferric chloride into a tray. So I've heated this ferric chloride up with warm water, and now you just pour it into the tray like so. Now this is reused stuff, so there are some particles in here, bits and pieces of stuff, but that shouldn't hurt anything. Okay, so what I do is I put a piece of tape on the back of the circuit board. I do not use air bubbles or anything like that to agitate the fluid. I just basically let it float on the surface of the ferric chloride. So what I'm going to do now is try and get some of this garbage off the top to one side. And then I kind of put it in on an angle like so. You'll see that it basically moves all the junk to one side as you put it in. Now as it's floating in there, I can agitate it back and forth like this. Now that'll take about 20 minutes to completely etch through. So I'll give you a progress report as I go along. Okay. Now it has been about 10 minutes now. And you can start to see some of the pattern showing through. It's etching. So you'll see it as a dark area on the circuit board. And I'm just going to zoom in here and see if maybe you can actually see that pattern. You can see it right here. There's sort of like a line along like this. So now it'll start to etch somewhat quicker here. I just keep agitating it back and forth like this every couple minutes. And the pattern starts to appear. You should be able to see that fairly clearly shortly. Yeah, you can see it right in here. 1, 2, 3. There's pads right here, and you can start to see it over here and over in here. Back in here, there's quite a bit showing now, see? Right in there. So it's etching very good. Okay, it's been about 15 minutes now and you can start to actually see really dark areas. Okay, and there's my logo coming out here. But another 5 to 10 minutes and it will be completely etched, ready to roll. Okay, there's just a couple of minutes left here. You can see as the copper gets eaten away, the pattern gets darker and darker and darker. So this is almost complete. I'll just keep agitating it a little more, and eventually I'll flip it over and have a look at the other side. Make sure everything is etched off where it's supposed to be. But she's looking good. Okay, so you can see now it's pretty well done. All the areas are very dark. Okay, so that means it's completely etched off the excess copper everywhere. So now I can just lift the board out and check the other side. And it's looking good. Let this drip off. And yes, I believe that is completely etched. That was a perfect one. See one little spot there. Nope, that's completely done. So I'll take that out now. Rinse the board off. So. Okay, so that just about completes my demonstration of the photo etch resist process. The only spot that I had a little piece of copper stay is right there beside a letter, which ain't gonna hurt nothing. So I'm just going to leave that the way it is. And this was where the flaw was in my pre-sensitized board where it peeled off, right there in the word Made in Canada. So that's going to be no big deal. But as you can see from this layout, or this after it's done etching, it's perfectly good method for creating your own circuit boards. Very solid copper. There's no breaks in them anywhere. And like I said, out of this 6x6 board here, I've got 17 boards here from that one piece of material. So now I've just got to drill them out, drill out all the little holes, and then I go over to my buddy's shop and use a metal break just to snap the board along the lines. You can see one of the lines right here. That's actually part of the circuit board. But and in the process, you can actually get logos and stuff like that embedded right in. Hoping you can see that. It's nice and clear. But I've got my name in here and a logo. The whole works, etched right into the circuit board. So I recorded this. Recorded this at 1080p, just so that you guys would be able to see this really fine detail, okay? So there you have it. Thanks for watching.